Okay, guys, back here. We were talking about this, whether this slide contains, have you heard completely clearly? This slide contains number one, first slide. Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Okay, okay. Yes, sir.
So now let us proceed to the second slide. Whether this slide, have you heard clearly there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a moment. Okay, this point, each block finishes execution independently of the other blocks. Is this clear to everyone there? If someone having about this point doubt, can ask to explain to explain. If people can ask, if someone having doubt about this point, each block finishes execution independently of other block. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if someone having doubt, kindly ask. Okay. So this answer we have seen, this explanation. Let us go to this one here. This is related to this very output here. If you see at zero simulation, just a moment here, let me change. What is happening here? Since we did not mention any such delay here, this delay we did not mention here. So it this delay, this sort of delay is not mentioned here. So meaning at zero simulation time, this M will get a value zero. This one. Now this one, what is happening here is at five, this A will get a value one, and cumulatively these two will be added up. So it is 30. Somewhere at 30. B will get a value 0. Now this one, independent of this one, just a moment. This complete block is independent of this block. This block. So what happens is here, irrespective, cumulatively this will not be added up here. This will not be added up here. Time will not be added up here. So at 10, here somewhere at 10, this X will get a value 0. And this will be added up cumulatively because they are there in the one initial statement. So that's why at 35, meaning at somewhere here at 35, this Y will get a value 1. And this block is independent of this three, this two, this block. So at 50, this is a system. What is this system? Can someone tell? Those who are learning, not earlier, already known people, don't answer. Try to answer those who are trying to learn, or somebody, somewhere you might have read, such people can answer this. What is this dollar finish? Is it what it is, first of all?
Task.
Okay, you, somebody said task. So is it system, what is the difference between system task and system function? This system function.
System function will return a value, but system task will not.
Okay. So other guys also have to speak. So nice answer, very good. So this one at 50, somewhere here at 50, so we are actually finishing our simulation. So these results are shown here. If you go here at this one, is the result. At 5, this is the result. At 10, at, so this is, these are actually, basically we're talking about the results. So now coming to this one here, the usage point here, initial blocks mostly you use, where you use them for initializing, this is one. Second is for monitoring. waveforms and other processes that must be executed only once during the entire simulation. This is the third one. 1, 2, 3 cases you can use this initial block. So you use, for example, here we have, you see this one here. This reg, and this is the clock. This clock is of reg type. This is initialized. This clock is initialized here. You just clock, CLK, clock, 0. You cannot write after declaring like this, and then you cannot write this way. So you have to write here under this initial. You have to write under this initial. Then this is valid. Without this, this statement is not correct. So this is one usage here, initializing for initial value assignment. So instead of the above method, clock variable can be initialized at the time of declaration. This provision also is there, such as this one. At the time of this one itself, here itself, this one, without putting this semicolon here, you assign here to the value 0 or whatever that is 1, and then put a semicolon. So this is also correct. So there are two ways here, guys. You have to understand this is also okay, and this is also okay. So these both are same. Now combined for data declaration and initialization. Here, this one, during declaration, you have something called module. And here you are declaring your IO codes or variables, whatever you are declaring. This is the declaration area. So here, this may be here, but the other way around is in the port itself here, this one here, you see, this is the port here, output port, and this is the output port, and we also have here this one. All these concepts we have to understand, that's why we are dealing with concepts today, this reg. At that time, you can assign like this, 0. This is okay. This output and the reg declaration, and then you are initializing this value here, this one. This is also okay. You really, the other way around is initial and then begin and then sum 0 and that CO 0. Semicolon, semicolon, and then end. So this entire thing is this. Both are same, but this is also allowed in the Verilog SGL. So that is one thing we must be aware. Now, other thing is this 2001 code declaration. This is the 2004 declaration here. Inside parenthesis we have here. This inside parenthesis, we have output, input. Unlike here, in the earlier case here, what is happening here is, here we have declared type declaration. And here only list. This one is only list. But if you see here, list plus plus initialization. These three activities are taking place. This is sum, your CO, A, B, C, R, these are list here. And this is the type declaration, port or type declaration. So you have declared output, input here, and initialization. you are initializing here with a zero and this one here with a zero. So like that. This is also allowed. One must be aware. Those who are learning language, they must be aware this is also possible. So now we have done with what is possible with initial. What is initial and what is possible with this initial. Now this is there with always. This always is always statement. Again the same story, that always statement constitute an always block. Meaning inside the always, if you write always and whatever inside comes, this is the always block. If people are saying my always block means, they might be having here one statement or multiple statements. That is your always block. So the always statement starts at time zero and executes the statements in always block continuously in looping fashion. So this is important. This is important. In looping fashion, it executes. This is important. So how do you control? If you don't put a timing, then your simulator will go in an infinite mode. So you will not see any simulation running. Actually, your simulation is actually running, but there will not be any output seen. Why? Because you did not put here, suppose say, always clock negation clock. Now, since this is running in a loop fashion, this is running in a loop fashion, what happens? This one simulation will not proceed here. It is infinite. It is at zero simulation itself. It is simulator is running at zero simulation itself. Simulation is running. So which is not proceeding actually, So in order to see that behavior, we have to have timing here, something like hash 5. For that use. So this timing is important, otherwise in infinite loop you will run just because of the behavior of this always. Is that clear, that point? Is this clear, that point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This statement is used to model a block of activity that is repeated continuously in a digital circuit. That is, again, not required. That is the clock. In test benches, we use mostly for generating the clocks. So, but this is used in RTL. Most frequently you see in RTL. That is design, not test bench. In a design. Design itself, you will see this always statement. Because it is supported by the synthesizer for ASIC designs. Initially is not supported. Again, we have to consult the vendor also. Tool vendor also we have to consult. Because again, that aspect also we have to see. If you are using always, if you are using initial, ultimate aim is to generate hardware. How do you generate hardware? Through that EDA tool called synthesizer. This EDA tool should support either this one or both. So in the FPGA cases, this is okay, acceptable. Initial, this FPGA cases, it is acceptable. In where, remember, in new learners especially, FPGA designs, you will not be having any problem usage of this initial. But if you are using for ASIC design, then this initial is not acceptable according to EDA tool, synthesizer. So that aspect also we have to see, or we have to understand. That's why this is used, because this is supported by all EDA tools. All EDA tools there in the market, ASIC EDA tools, all of them will support this always statement. But they don't support this initial. That's why we have to avoid usage of this initial in a ASIC design description. So that is the point. Now coming to this example, if you see this one here, this initial is used to give the value to the clock. Because if you see the clock here, this is reg. Yes, of course, this is also output. But why reg is required? Anything that is there inside the initial or inside the always, and that is there on left hand side, LHS side or target side, or target side, that must be a variable data type. That must belong to variable data. Among variable data type, this reg is one. So that's why being in initial, since you are assigning something to the clock, it cannot be an output alone. If output alone, then simulator will throw error. So new learners, especially we have to understand these data types in initial classes. Those who missed it can see the YouTube already recorded videos are there. But telling you that this output is actually implicitly belongs to wire type. Belongs to wire. Implicitly. What is wire means? It is a net data type. This net data type, inside initial you cannot assign. Inside initial, suppose say there is a Y, this is the Y, so you cannot assign. Or inside always, if Y is there, you cannot assign. So here, what I had to put here, I had to also put here reg. Then this is the, okay. So that's how the compiler is working. So we have to understand how, what compiler instructions are. So anyway, coming to the point here, what we are doing, we are initializing here at zero simulation time. At zero simulation time, we are initializing the clock. Now what we are doing is, let us say this is not there, for example, this is not there. You are thinking that you are actually negating your clock, generating the clock by negating like that. But what happens is, as being said, at zero simulation time, it starts this always simulation, because we already read here, it starts at zero simulation. This is the point, key point, we should not forget, this is important point. So what happens is, at zero simulation time, it keeps repeating. So over simulation, when you are trying to see the waveform here, you will not see. Why? Because it is running at zero simulation only. That's why this time is important. Now what happens for every at zero though executed, it will wait till the 10, and then something happens. It will wait for 10, something happens like that, according to the definition here. In this case, it is toggling. So now we are stopping here at this time unit. If you don't use this one, by default simulator will run to some time unit. By default, every simulator will have some default if a user not mentioning this one. So till that default time it will run. But if you want to stop before that default time, so you have to mention this one. Why we are mentioning this one means we want to stop, we want to run our simulation till that time. So these basics should be clear. Now what happens if you don't use this one? Because this reg is type of clock, clock is type reg here. So the default value is X. So now what we are trying to do, if it is not there, we are trying to negate the clock. With unknown value. So if you see the table, earlier classes we have discussed, there was a truth table given by the compiler people. Compiler people have said that if zero is there, if you are negating, then one will come. If one is there, then zero will come. If X is there, X will come. Means if you don't do this one, you will not generate a clock, meaningful clock you will not generate. This meaningful clock will not come. What comes is unknown value will come. Yeah, something like that is unknown value will come. So that's why be careful you can you have to you should be aware of the table also, how this in the data flow level modeling we have seen that. So that's why we have to initialize with a known value, and then we have to do whatever. So that is the point about that. Now this one is the same about that. So here few points that left hand side procedural your assignment, this one. What we call, so far we have studied the terminology is a structured procedure. One is the terminology, just we should be aware, structured procedure or procedural constructs. The terminology we should not be forgetting. Procedural constructs means what? That two, that is one initial, the other is always. Now anything comes inside here is a procedural assignment. If procedural assignments are more, then we have to have that begin and end. Otherwise, not required. So this procedural assignment that is there on the left hand side here, it could be a range, it could be an integer, it could be a real, or it could be a time. Meaning what? Basically, we are telling that it should belong to register type. It should belong to a register type. It should be a register variable. So because according to 1995, we know one is a net data type, the other is a register data. According to 2001, this register is, this register, are you people there? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This register data type renamed in the year 2005 as a variable data type. So we should be aware. So this register usage is in that context. So that should be this type. Or it also can be like this, a bit select of these variables, bit select meaning like this. Those who are not aware, you should know that if you have a vector 3:0 is A, and you have another vector 5:0, it is B. Now suppose say we are talking about the bit select. In this, I want one A of 2, it's a bit select. And this one here, B of 3 is a bit select. We are selecting that particular bit. The part select of these variable also is allowed. Here in this part select, I want to do like, suppose say, A 2:1. Only these bits I want to take from this. That is also allowed. And B, I want to take in this 4:2. So that is part select. So a concatenation of any of the above. So that is also allowed. You must be knowing concatenation means we have that this operator. Using this, you can have A of 2:1, comma B of anything that according to your requirement, again everything. But there is a provision that you can club them. This is here. You can club them and you can assign something whatever. So here, if you see, this is 2-bit size, and here 2-bit size. Suppose I am assigning here 4 tick B 1011. So this is allowed. So one should be aware what is allowed on the left hand side. On the left hand side of this procedural assignment. Procedural assignment means that comes here, that comes inside your always or inside your initial. This is the procedural assignment. So the right hand side here can be any expression that evaluates a value. So that could be anything that is suppose say A plus B or something whatever. So that sort of thing. We'll see the examples, so don't worry. But you should understand that the important point is left hand side should belong to either of this. That is, in short, saying it should be a variable data. That is all the point that we have to remember. Now, yesterday we talked about blocking assignments, and we also talked about non-blocking assignments. So that's why these slides I'm skipping, because we already discussed yesterday. So let us go to application of non-blocking assignment. That is important. Application. So what is the application? So here, suppose say you have this one here, for example, this one. So to eliminate a race condition, to eliminate race condition. Suppose say this, you observe this one. This one. So your intention is, you have A equal to 3, B equal to 2. Your intention is, after execution, A should get a 2 and B should get a 3. So with this, you cannot say what is going to happen, because that depends upon compiler, how compiler is going to execute them. Because this is also at zero simulation time, this is also at zero simulation time. When positive edge clock coming, then this is assigned to here, this is assigned to here. Suppose say compiler is treating this for a while, seconds before this statement. Then what happens? B will get A will get a value 2. What is that now having? A having a value 2. So now what is that happening? You are assigning this to here, B. But now what happens if this gets executed? If this is the is not treated by the compiler. This is treated by the compiler. Now what happens? A, that is 3, is assigned to B, and that value you are assigning to again to the A. So meaning what? There is no certainty. There is no certainty if you use this one. We cannot say compiler will execute this first and second is this one, or you cannot say compiler will execute this one first and this one first second. So like that, you cannot say compiler how it is going to treat. There is no certainty how compiler going to treat them. There is no certainty. Certainty is not there. This may happen or this may happen. So there is no certainty. So that is race condition. We avoid this one with the help of this one. This one. We already studied yesterday, it's a non-blocking assignment operator. As you know, it's a non-blocking assignment operator. So what it does, it reads first. It is doing actually in a three steps actually. This somewhere here, I kept here. So it is doing in a three stages. First stage, this is the second stage, and this is the third stage. So these three stages it is actually doing. What it is doing, I will tell you. Without going to the theory stuff, let us go to that one. First it reads what is the value. So it reads the value. So this is say old value. So what is read by the compiler and stored somewhere in the memory, in the temporary memory here? These values are read and stored here by the compiler. Now, when this event is occurring, what it has read and stored, old values it has read and old values it has stored in the temporary memory. And then it performs the assignment. This is old values first, reading and storing, and then assigning. Reading old value, storing the old value in some temporary location, and then third step is assigning. All three activities are happening at this time. So old value of the B is 2. So this A will get 2. And now what is B? B we here is assigned with the A. What is A? A is a old value. Old value. What is old value? Old value is 3. So this 3 is assigned. So without any such a race condition, without any race condition, this is happily performing this activity. This activity, swapping activity. Concurrent. This is the concurrent behavior here. This is the concurrent behavior. Parallelly, at once. So how is that possible? It's possible because of these 3 activities. First, reading old values. Reading old values. And then storing. And then assigning. And then all these 3 are done by this one, that is less than or equal to. This is called assignment operator, non-blocking assignment operator. Is that clear to everyone there?
Yes, sir.
So that is very important. But what is the only possibly interview question could be this one. What is the only drawback that it is having? That is actually good. This one is actually good. This is a digital design point of view. Your digital design point of view, it is very, 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 very good. But only disadvantage is, this downside is, it performance increase memory usage. It consumes memory usage. Increase in memory usage. Memory usage. Memory usage means what? Anyone having idea? What is meant by memory usage?
No, sir.
Any already working, anyone already, those who learned the subject already, just attending this course for added purpose or any other reason. Do you have any idea about this? Increase in memory usage means what?
I think it will have some extra flip-flop thing.
No, wrong. Okay, no problem. That's good try. I appreciate you just... spoke. That is good. I appreciate. The point here is, I will just a moment. I had to come out of this. Is this seen by everyone? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now this is your CPU. And you have here your RAM. And you have your hard disk here. And your software, that simulator. EDA simulator. When you click, is your monitor. You see icon here, your ISE icon. So you are clicking this. So you're clicking, meaning what? Actually, this is loaded from the hard disk to your RAM, and now you are performing here through your keyboard activities to the CPU. And the program is running in the RAM. That's why we say if 8 GB is there, it is faster. If 16 GB is there, it is much faster. Nowadays, 8 GB minimum is, nowadays applications, 8 GB is minimum. So we say minimum requirement is 8 GB. If 16 GB is there, means that is good. 32 GB is there, means very good. We are talking about this RAM. So what is that doing that the non-blocking assignment operator, what it is doing actually, it is first reading and storing in some temporary storage. Storing meaning what? Space required. Where is that space? This space is here in the RAM. It consumes the RAM. if your designs are our academic purpose for understanding purpose, our designs are very small, some maybe 32 lines, maybe 52 lines, but in industry it may be 5000 lines or 15000 lines, such a big designs. In that big designs, if we have this one, that is non blocking assignment operator, this simulator will take more, what it will take more space. Why? Because this assignment operator is used. What it does during simulation, it reads and it stores. It storing means space is required. So that way some effect is seen. That's why it is said here that the downgrade is only so the downside of this is increase in memory usage. Is that clear now?
Yes sir.
So that could be an interview question to the new learners, those who want to get into RTL at the entry level, front end designer, digital front end designer, are actually RTL developers, RTL coder. So for them it could be a possible question. Now coming to the sequential and parallel block.